Hi everyone.
Welcome to KK Kitchens.
Okay, Hepin, what are we going to do today?
Tomato ketchup and red chili sauce.
Okay, tomato ketchup and red chili sauce. So to make tomato ketchup, I have taken 7 to 8 pieces of whole tomatoes. I have taken a juice tomato, so it will be more juicier and you get a lot of sauce. And I'm adding it into the cooker. So to this, I am going to add 6 to 7 cloves of garlic and a little bit of ginger. I've added 2 teaspoons of salt. 2 tablespoons of sugar and 3 red chilies. I'm adding 1/2 cup of vinegar, white vinegar, to it. Okay, now let's get it cooked to 3 to 4 whistles. Okay, now the ingredients are well cooled and now we are going to blend it in a blender. I have not added any water. But because of the tomato contains a lot of water, so we have enough water for grinding. Okay, the puree is ready and now we are going to filter it. So the puree is ready, now we are going to heat it. So we are going to add the puree to the pan. At this point we can taste and see if sugar and salt content is enough or not. If not enough, then you can add little more. So I've added a little more salt and a little more sugar, and you can also add brown sugar if you want, and the color will be much better with the brown sugar. The classic ketchup is always made with the white sugar. So I have added a little bit of brown sugar only to enhance the taste and color. Now if you want to know whether the ketchup is done or not, so you have to keep a drop of ketchup into the plate and you have to keep it slanting to check if any water is coming down. If water comes down first, down, and then the ketchup is still not ready. And now the water is not coming, so only the ketchup is coming, so the ketchup is ready now. Looks very delicious, and now we are going to move it to the bottle. The homemade tomato ketchup is ready and bottled, so we are going to use it for a lot of recipes. We can store the ketchup outside for 7 to 10 days. And if you want to keep it longer, you can also store it inside the fridge. So now we are going to make a red chili sauce. To make the red chili sauce, I have taken 2 types of chilies. One is Kashmiri chili for the color, and this is for the spiciness, the regular red chili. Kashmiri chili will give the color for red chili sauce. So the chilies are ready now. So I'm going to cut this red chilies into 3 pieces. Now the chili is cut into pieces and I'm going to add a little bit of hot water. I'm going to soak it for 1/2 hour. Okay, now the red chili is soaked well and we are going to blend it now in the blender. I'm adding all the red chili from the top, leaving out all the seeds on the bottom, so we are not going to use the seeds. And I'm going to add 1 tomato. Okay, so the red chilies and tomatoes added. Next, I'm going to add a little bit of garlic, a little bit of ginger. I'm going to add 1.5 spoon of sugar. Just 1 teaspoon of salt. I'm going to add a little bit of water for blending. Now I'm going to blend this. Blending is done. We're going to filter it and then we are going to cook it. So the puree is ready and we are going to cook it with vinegar to make the final sauce. We have heated the pan, added the sauce to the pan. I've taken 1/4 cup of vinegar, white vinegar, and I'm going to add it in this. Now we can taste and see if salt or sugar is lesser, and you can still add it. It's okay, the red chili sauce is ready now. Now the red chili sauce is cooled, and now we are going to transfer it to the bottle. This is tomato ketchup. Okay, you can also make it at home, and sauce made at home is always healthier than buying from outside. And if you are able to make the sauce at home, please make it at home and use the homemade sauce for all your recipes. Thank you for watching.
Bye.